Hi, my name is Phil Rutt from Pico Technology. Today we're actually going to be using the PicoScope with our standard coloured leads, and we're going to do a test on the O2 sensor. So we're going to show you how to connect, how to set the screen up from a manual setting, and how that when we actually change the earthing points, that can actually change how good our signal is. We also have the feature on filtering where we can go to active filtering and filter things. So we're going to show you how to carry the test out, how to record the notes, and how by changing the earthing points it will affect the signal. Right, so what we've done on the screen, we've actually gone to 2 volts and we've got to 10 seconds. The reason for going to 2 volts is the fact that sometimes we get lots of interference, so we get our over voltage reading on the screen, a little red marker that comes up the top. So what we're going to do is we just start the car up. We're going to start the software up. Just rev the car up and then get the working temperature. So, you can see that every so often we may over voltage because of interference. So I'm going to show you how by changing our earthing points will affect our signal. So we're going to take it off of the engine and put it onto the battery. And we can see again how our signal has totally changed again. We've got a very wide signal, lots of interference. And now what we're going to do is also go onto the sensor itself. And you can see that even there, earthing the sensor out, we still have a lot of interference. So we'll actually go back to our bolt on the side of the engine to show you just how much cleaner that signal can be. Now, we also have a feature within the software, if we go to the little arrow drop down box, where we can actually put active filter on. And you will now see, as the software works, once it gets to the end of the screen, it will actually clean up the signal quite a lot. So what we'll do, stop the software, turn the engine off, and you can then actually see how we put the active filtering on and clean the signal. If we put too much of an active filter on, then of course we will actually have a problem that it may look make the signal look too clean, as is some of the comments to some of our signals. So we try and capture things as we see them, and we may filter them or may not. I tend to not like to filter things too much, otherwise we get too clean a signal. Okay, thanks very much for your time looking at this video.